So let's start demo time. Okay. So hi everybody, today I'm gonna, I hope quite quickly, show you a demo time web part which I created for the for the SharePoint hackathon, which was this year. And okay, I'm a dev, I'm a part of the PMP core team, I'm a maintainer of some projects maybe you know or use, like CLI for Microsoft 365 or SPFx toolkit or other. So yeah, feel free to reach me out if you need any kind of help. And what's this demo all about? So I'm going to present a small hack I created for the SharePoint hackathon this year. And what it does, it creates, like adds an additional presentation mode for your SharePoint pages. So then it turns your SharePoint, every page can become like a small demo, like a demo time, like a presentation. So without changing it, like each section to a slide. So it's actually trying to enhance each section as a slide and add this enhancement. And I was like, the idea came from actually the hackathon itself. I didn't have anything I could add like publicly, so I had to create something pretty quickly and didn't have a lot of time for the hackathon. And since this hackathon was also possible to issue like a site you created, and there was a lot of demos about like movies, about the site they created in SharePoint, I thought, well, why do we don't have this kind of feature already in SharePoint to turn your site to a presentation, to like a presentation mode, to a presentation, to slides, to whatever, so it will be easier to explain your site. So this was my idea, and I was inspired by actually this extension I'm using now, Demo Time VS Code, created by the magnificent Elio. And the aim is to stop switching context between like movies, PowerPoint, but maybe stay in the browser or in the context of your work. And it's not a 100% production ready solution what we'll be showing today. It's just a proof of concept. So if you want to adapt it to your case, you still probably will need to put a bit of love and coding to it. And it's a hack totally, because this web part is manipulating DOMs. It's using DOM as its API. It's enhancing it with additional CSS and injecting its own, I will be presenting it in a while in the code, injecting its own HTML in SharePoint standard UI. So it's something totally not recommended, by the way. So what was a hackathon, so I created a hack, right? Okay, short demo, let's jump to the browser. So this is a page, like a welcome page for a new employee introduced, created by from a template. And if we go to the edit mode of this page, you can drop this web part like any other web part. It only has some UI presented when it's edit mode. It has those three emojis, nothing else, no settings, anything. It's just a placeholder, so you see if that it's there. And once you publish it, it's hidden from the UI, so it doesn't like touch any of your content, doesn't add additional padding, anything else. But then you have this additional button demo here in the header, in the secondary header of your page. And when you click on it, it treats every section of your page as a slide and present this not fancy, not nice looking tooltip, but with basic information that is attached to this section. You can then use the next button or the previous to move between sections, like you would move between slides and let's say PowerPoint. You can also use keyboards, so there are shortcuts. You don't have to like click around, and you also have the stop button and the play button. So for play, it's Control Alt P, I think, and it turns to the presentation mode. Okay, and those tooltips are coming from a SharePoint list, which is present on the same site. And this list has a demo time list, has comments attached to every section of a specific page, because there's a demo per page, not per list site, but per page on a site. You can create a demo per page on a site. And if there's no tooltip added, then no, there's nothing present here in the upper right corner. Okay, so this is pretty simple solution and how it was created. Let's move. Okay, so the solution is, you can download it already from the SPFx web part gallery that our PMP community maintained. It's quite simple. It has only one component and service, which the service is pretty simple. Just it takes the items from the list. And as you can see, so it will only work in the context of a SharePoint page. If it's presented in Teams, it's used as a web part in Teams, like a personal app, it won't do anything. Then what we do, so as I said, this is a hack, it's not recommended. We check, we query for a specific CSS selector to find this gray header. And if it's not there, it won't crash your page. So even though it's a hack, it won't like, you know, won't work, it won't do anything wrong with your page, it will just not load any of the UI. But if it will find those CSS, then it will add this start the demo button, which I presented a while ago. And this is why it's also recommended, because this is something not recommended, because this is something we cannot control. We as developers, this is something Microsoft maintains. So if Microsoft will think that, okay, let's change the name of this class, then this web part will just stop working. Pretty cool. And then when it's not in edit mode, we just add additional HTML coming from this method. I will show it in a while. And if it's so, it only like adds this button when it's not in edit mode. When it is in edit mode, then it just, you know, gives you a placeholder so we can see it's there. And so this is like this web part is really, really simple. I didn't use any framework here, just so no framework template. So it may be really a simple concept for especially someone beginning with SPFx to learn something that is not recommended, maybe should learn, but there are some basic concepts you could learn from it, like how to check if the page is in edit mode or you're in the context of a SharePoint site only, not in Teams. So there are some things that are quite neat and every SPFx developer should know of. And then when we inject this HTML, we attach additional event receivers for it and click. So for example, to move to the next slide, which actually just do a bit of magic with CSS and adjust the scroll position. And then we also attach event receivers to like keyboard click items. So you can, as I've shown, maybe shown, you have to believe me, I was only using keyboard, not the mouse, clicking event to move to the next section. So move to the next slide. Okay, so what are the use case of such a web part? Let's make this slide a bit bigger. So like in the example I've shown, employee onboarding, we all have new employees in our companies and we need to go them through the process of, okay, this is the HR side, this is the process, here you can find the forms and stuff like that. Usually there's a SharePoint site for it, or if a couple of SharePoint sites or pages and stuff like that. So this kind of to do it asynchronously without like going through this new employee, we could direct him or her to the SharePoint site, to a specific onboarding page, and then he or she could start the demo time of this page and go it by their own. Another thing is like a department site introduction. So I don't know, but many companies have their departments, and they departments tend to have their site collections in SharePoint. And each of those departments are sometimes structured differently. They have different pages, different resources, and they want to show off their goodies. So what they could do, they can also do a demo for their homepage of their department site. So every employee that will enter their department site would get like a structure guidance where he or her can find anything valuable that department gives. So this is also like a guided tour of a SharePoint site you can create for any SharePoint site. So these like three top of my head use cases you could do with this kind of web part. And thank you. That's all. This was my really short demo and my hack for the SharePoint hackathon. I hope you liked it and give it a try, and happy coding, everybody. Back to you, Chris.